Hello everyone, and let's check out another exciting chess game by Mikel Tal. And in this chess game, Mikel Tal has the white pieces, and his opponent is a player with no name. And this game was played in 1973. Let's check out how this game went on. Mikel Tal starts the game with playing e4, c5, the Sicilian defense. And in this chess game, we have the classic Nidorov variation of the Sicilian defense, a6, bishop to g5 by Tal, e6, f4, bishop to e7, queen to f3, queen to c7, and Tal castled from the queen side. Knight from b to d7, bishop to d3, b5, rook from h to e1, bishop to b7, queen to g3, b4. Attacking the knight. Well, a normal human being, a normal, mortal player, would defend his knight, but not Mikel Tal. He likes to attack. Retreating the knight is very passive for Tal. He played knight to d5. Unbelievable. Sacrificing the knight. And Black didn't capture the knight with the pawn. He captured back with the knight. Let's take it back. If e takes on d5, then capturing back and opening the e-file. Of course, white has some attacking opportunities. The king is in the middle. But of course, against a strong defensive player, white may end up losing the game. So this was a risky move by Mikel Tal. Tal usually liked to gamble in his chess games. This is why we like his chess games. It is always risky and fun to watch. Let's get back to the real game. So in the game, Mikel Tal is sacrificing the knight, knight to d5. And black captured back with the knight. Knight takes on d5. E takes on d5. Knight to c5. Attacking the bishop. D takes on e6 by Tal, capturing one more pawn. And black captured the bishop, capturing back with the rook. Rook takes on d3. And also lifting the rook. f6, attacking the bishop. Bishop to h4. And attacking again. Well, trapping the bishop. So, what else? Mikel Tal captured the pawn. But then, rook to g5 by black. Maybe black was smiling at this moment of the game. Because this is winning the bishop, maybe. If pushing the pawn, defending the bishop, then black can push the pawn, push the h-pawn. Well, it is white to move. And Mikel Tal played another very aggressive move. As you know, Mikel Tal doesn't like to play passive moves. So he played bishop takes on e7 by Tal, sacrificing the queen. And black captured the queen. Rook takes on g3. Rook takes on g3. And Mikel Tal is threatening to play rook to g8. If king takes bishop, rook to g7, winning the queen. So not capturing the bishop and defending the queen, queen to c5. Well, if king takes on e7, then rook to g7, check, moving the king and capturing the queen. And white is much better. White is winning. Black must resign at this moment of the game. So this is why, after rook takes on g3, we have queen to c5. But bishop to f6 now, by Mikel Tal. Can you see the threat? Rook to g8, checkmate. So black is defending, king to f8, what else? And lining the rook with the king. After sacrificing the queen, Mikel Tal is going after the king. Tal said, "You can have my queen, but I will have your king." Lining the rook with the king. And actually, there is no reasonable defense. So black played rook to c8. Mikel Tal played a move, and black resigned. Bishop to d8 by Tal. This is check. And black resigned on the spot. Because black is getting checkmated, and there is no defense. So let's check out the possible continuation. Moving the king, the only move. And then, rook to g8. Checkmate. As you can see, there is no defense. And Black is getting checkmated. What an incredible chess game by Mikel Tal. This chess game was like a soccer match with lots of goals. Or maybe a boxing match with lots of knockdowns and then knockouts in the end. An epic chess game by Mikel Tal. An amazing chess game. It was like a thriller movie. What a game. And thank you for watching. And I hope to see you next time. Take care and bye-bye.